Hey everyone, this is my moving library painting, and I'm Angry Mikko. I think the idea for this painting came from this childhood memory that I was living in this place that had this library truck come by. And when I was a kid, I just felt like that's the most magical thing ever. There's a whole building filled with books that comes over, and it's gonna be gone, and it's a limited amount of time that you can borrow a book, and then it will return someday. And I just thought it was so awesome, so I kind of wanted to recreate that experience from memory, but I did it in the way that I remember, not the way that it actually is. And since I have this kind of romantic way of remembering everything, I just went with that memory. So this library that is on wheels, it resembles a greenhouse, and it's moving through these hills in the night. I designed the wheels so that they have this very long chassis so that it can keep the library as still as possible. I imagine this library moving very slowly through the road when it's going to the next place, and I can almost imagine what it would be to see it coming from behind a hill and slowly going into the distance. I think the whole painting phase of this piece was so difficult for me for many reasons, because the whole visual appeal of this image leans on this certain kind of frame, and it has this impression of light coming from inside. And I usually want to discourage anybody for doing a lot of details, but here I think getting a certain level of detail for the library and to have this kind of like impression of 3D space and light, it took a long time for me. And at one point I was kind of losing hope, but I was kind of not I wouldn't say optimistic, but I was more kind of rebellious against this inner voice that like, you should quit, you can't do this, it's not looking good, try another idea. But I was kind of more, I'm not gonna listen to this negative voice in my head, I'm gonna choose the positivity side of it, and I'm just gonna do it anyway. I don't want the negative talk in my head, tell me what to do, I can make my own goddamn decisions. So when you don't have confidence, at least be stubborn. I don't know if this is at all good advice, but for me it worked. I'm really happy that I finished this one, because now it looks like that idea that I had, and you can see it too, so I'm doing this for you guys. For the construction of the box of this library, I tried using this 3D program app on iPad, but I don't know if that really helped at all, because I only ended up using like the far edges of that box. You probably see a glimpse of it in the beginning, but really I constructed the library just based on the normal vanishing point grid, perspective grid, that you can use in Procreate. Like, that's completely fine. I think for these rounded rooftops, it might have helped more if I had more skill with it. I'm just gonna probably keep practicing it, and if it becomes easy, I will use it more. But for now, I don't see a reason to take out a 3D program for something this simple looking. A grid does just fine. I've used SketchUp a lot in the past, but that program to me is so intuitive to use that it actually helps when I'm doing a really complex scene. Like, for example, if I have a city scene that has buildings in different angles, then SketchUp helps with that. It's not easy to just use a vanishing point grid. But for most things, I always try to like consider the time it takes. So almost 99% of the time, just using a perspective grid, it's faster than a 3D program, unless you're doing an incredibly elaborate and complex scenes. So I think for this painting, the most rewarding phase was, of course, the final editing in the end, when all the layers are flattened and I could do this kind of like glowy light effects on an additive layer on top of it. And when the whole thing came together, it was just like, yes, I'm glad I was so stubborn. This is what I was looking for. It's done. Okay, I'm Mikko, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.